I was unable to get the MySQL direct connection to work on the computer I normally do these tutorials on. I don't know why. It did work. Then I deleted it to show you how I installed it, and now I cannot get it to work on that machine. But I have it on another machine, and we're going to continue on by opening up the MySQL 5.6 command line client. I'm going to type in our password, secret one. I want to create a new database. This one will be called odb83_mysqldb. And then I need the semicolon. Enter. And I will close this by clicking on the X. Now let's open up LibreOffice and create a LibreOffice base document. I'm going to click on base database. We want to connect to an existing database. This one will be a MySQL database. Next, we're going to connect directly. The database name will be odb83_mysqldb. This will be on the localhost. Next, we need the username of root, our only user at this point. Password required. Let's test that connection. Typing in the password, secret one. We see that that was successful. Yes, I will register the database and open the database for editing and finish. Let's give this the name odb83mysqldb and save. Now when we open this up, we see the MySQL tables as well as our odb81, odb82. We've got one here called Sequila, Test, and World. The reason we're seeing all of these databases is we connected direct to the MySQL database, and these are all the schemas that the root login can change or edit. The MySQL and the performance schema are part of the MySQL databases. We should probably not touch those. The Sequila, Test, and World, these are test databases out there, and some of them have test data and connections. We are just going to focus on the ODB83. I don't have that one selected now, but I want to create a new table. And we're going to show that this doesn't matter. I'm going to create a new table in Design View. I'm going to create a field name of emp-id, and I want this one to be an integer, and the emp-name text 100, that's fine. Let's save this. Now we need to choose what schema or database that we want to save this under. I want this under the odb83mysqldb, and I'll give this the name tbl_emp. And it seems we forgot the primary key. Let's cancel. Right click, primary key, and let's make that auto value yes. Now let's save it as 83 tbl_emp. Close. We don't need to save the changes again. If I open up our ODB83, we see our employee table. Let's create another table. This is going to be PHN ID, and this will be an integer, PHN-number, text is fine. Then we also want the EMP-ID, so we can connect these two. and that will be an integer. Let's make the phone ID our primary key, make the auto value yes, and save. Under the ODB83 schema, we will make this TBL_PHN. Let's close this, save the changes, no. But I want to add some data, so I'm going to open up the employee. We will make our first employee, Smith, the second one, Jones, and the third one, Brown. Let's add in some phone numbers. The first one will be 555-1212. That will go to employee ID 1. 555-9999. That will go to employee number 2. We have one more. 555-9876. That will go back to employee number 1. Just so we have some data out there. Let's add in a relationship, tools, relationships. This is taking a minute or two to open up the relationships. And we see that we've got a lot of relationships already created. Most of these are for the SQL database. That was one of the sample databases created for us. We also have ODB81 out there. And we are going to add in some tables. These will be our ODB83 MySQL DB employee table and phone table. And I want employee ID to employee ID. We created the one to many. I'll save this. Now let's create the form. I'm going to use the wizard to create the form. I want to choose my ODB83 employee table, both fields. Now I want to add the subform of the phone number table. We can add in all the fields. Next, I'm going to make my main form labels left columnar, and below that the data sheet view for the subform. We're just going to select all the defaults, including the default name. And finish. So it looks like this is going to work. We've got employee ID 1 Smith with the two phone numbers. Our second one, Jones, has got the one phone number. Third one, Brown, has zero phone numbers. Jones, we're going to change that name to Jones-Johnson. And we see we've got a problem. NES, but when I try and go beyond what it was, it's not allowing me. To fix this, let's close this and open it back up in Edit. I'm going into General, and under this Max Text Length, it has 0. We had a value of 100 was our max length, so I'm going to change that. Close it, save it, and let's go into Design Mode and change Jones to be Jones-Johnson. And that seems to work. Going next, let's add a phone number. I should make that smaller. Now if we go over to the third one, we can make a phone number, 555-5555. Save. Clicking on the name. Get Jones Johnson, and there's Brown with the phone number. So connecting directly if you can get it to work, will work with subforms.